Hey there, welcome to SAP Build Process Automation product updates, the top five features of the first half of 2023. My name is John, and today I am joined by Jesse.
Hello, everybody. Now, here at SAP Build Process Automation, we're all about improving your business efficiency with low-code, no-code capabilities. That's why we're super excited to share with you these top five product updates so you can watch and learn how they work in action. Let's go.
First off, let's talk about subprocesses. You can add subprocesses to your main process, and they're often used to segment complex processes, making them much more manageable and easier to understand. To do this, click on the plus icon and choose subprocesses. Here, we are configuring the process inputs and outputs. Instead of having to recreate the same set of steps multiple times, you can create a subprocess once and reference it in one parent or multiple processes. This not only saves time, but also ensures consistency and reduces the risk of errors. Now, let's call an API trigger to start the validation process so that it can start the validation process for invoices coming in. Now, we're finishing up the rest of our process by adding the decisions and approval components. Nice! We just modularized our process within our main process approval, and now we can leverage them in one or more multiple master processes without duplicating efforts.
Let's learn how to add email lists as forms recipients. First, in the Process Builder canvas, we select the approval form in which we want to add the emails to. On the right-hand side, we configure Process Started By option to send the email to the process initiator, in this case, myself. Below, you will be able to add multiple email addresses separated by comma to be notified about the form or the order. Once we've added the recipients, simply click on Save button and proceed to release and deploy the project. Now, let's check out the form which your process participant fills. After completing all of the required details of the sales order, they simply click on Submit. And let's check out my inbox application. And we see that the order form has been successfully received to my email address.
Next up is configuring OAuth and email destinations. With SAP Build Process Automation, you can configure a simple mail transfer protocol, mail server, for mail notifications to notify any specific contacts about status changes in your active project automation. This will first require authentication, so in this example, we're going into the mail administrator settings and authenticate. And once that's done, let's go into our SAP Build settings and click Backend Configuration and select Mail Server. Now, let's set up our mail destination in the SAP BTP cockpit. Here, we need to configure the mail destination and any other additional properties. Once configured correctly, you can send a test email to make sure that it's working. And here it is. Now users can be notified about status changes and updates.
Let's look at how to set due dates in forms. To begin, I select the notification form that I want to set the due date for. First, I locate the due date function on the lower right-hand side. Here, we can specify the number of days in which the response or the task is expected. Similarly, I follow the same process for all of the other forms, configuring the due dates using the days input field. Let's now see how the process participant fills out the approval request form. Once all the necessary details of the sales order are completed, the process participant can now also define the desired response time, which in this case is 1 day. Now, let's check out my inbox if we have the order confirmation. the approval has been successfully requested and the response due date is set for 1 day.
Lastly, we have reusable rules. With this enhanced feature, you can easily and effortlessly integrate reusable rules into other rules, providing a specific functionality across multiple business rules. Now let's see this in action. First, select your decision and click on Add Rule. In this example, let's create a validation rule for an invoice approval process. From our Get Invoice Exceptions decision, let's set a rule. As a text rule, we'll make this a validate rule that checks for supplier information. And once you're done, release and deploy your project. Here, we created different validation rules as reusable rules and combined them into one main rule. When this main rule is executed, the rule engine will internally call the reusable rules and return the list of validation errors. Now, in this instance, we can monitor that the rule is working and the supplier details matches with the purchase order. By applying the reusable rule function, you can use it as expressions in other rules. Reusable rules are great when you have a common function rule that you want to build once and want to use multiple times. And that's it. That's the top 5 features that we've introduced in the first half of 2023. Thanks for watching.
Are you interested in trying out the product for yourself? Then head on over to our website for a click-through product tour at sap.com/build-automation. Thanks again and see you later.